back to basics. There we go. Question. I'm having trouble putting it all together, reading a question, figuring out what to do in cardio issues. Can you go over cardio? So just going over cardio is, I came up with some highlights, some tips, because it's a really broad subject. The first thing I would say when you're going to be dealing with a cardiovascular system, these are the key tips is you need to know your anatomy, you need to know the physiology of disease processes, and you need to think about what you're using as your resource materials. Because actually, the vascular system, it's just so diverse. It has so many working parts, and it's, you know, you think of septic as being something bad, but you know, it is. It's systemic. It goes through the entire body. So, again, it's very important to know those three points. I put a little picture up there of, you know, just a little hint of the vascular system and the anatomy, and all of those veins and arteries have specific names. Now, you don't need to know those, but know that a lot of those are based on other anatomy, like the bones. That's where you get the subclavian artery up here by your clavicle, things like that. So that helps to know not just the anatomy of the vascular system, but the anatomy of bones is also very important for the coder. Scroll down just a little bit, and I also have some points that I wanted to say about how the heart works. I would say the first thing that if I'm wanting to understand the anatomy of the vascular system and cardiology, I would go straight to the structure of the heart. There is tons of resources out there for you to use, but knowing the main parts of the heart, the ventricles, the veins going in and the arteries and where they go, that is going to be essential. Know the different valves, and some of the valves in the heart have different names, so you want to make sure you know them. And then again, for disease process, not just the the atrium and the ventricles, but I would also bone up on your terminology. So if you are dealing with something that's a myocardium, that would be the muscle of the heart, you know, pericardium around the heart, things like that. That will be very helpful for you as you're trying to do coding for cardiovascular. And I know that seems kind of basic, but it really is what is the most helpful. We do this in Chapter 10 of our PBC course, and I always tell them, heads up, you know, when you get to Chapter 10, it's going to kick you a little bit. And what I have found is that the people that take the time to really learn the anatomy of the heart and familiarize yourself with them do much better at that Chapter 10 than people that try to just go straight in and figure it out. Also, as we go down on this slide a little bit, I wanted to make a point, and I know you've heard Lorraine say this and myself say this, Google is your friend, and that is a fantastic resource. So Google Images, you know, if I'm not sure about something, and don't think that, you know, just because, you know, I'm up here telling you or lecturing you that I know it all. I don't. I'm often jumping into Google and getting a picture of the heart or another organ system just so I can find, you know, tune and say, oh, well, you know, I was thinking it was this, but I'm not sure. And then that's just it's almost like instant gratification to be able to bring up an image that is labeled like this so that you can find the actual structure of the circulatory system in the lower limbs, you know, quickly. Some other reference tools that I would use is drugs.com. Now, that is going to tell you the type of medications and what medications are used. And you're thinking, well, how will that help me with my coding? But when you are reading a patient's chart and you're looking at an individual encounter and you see that a patient's on a certain medication, you'll be able to draw that line and say, oh, well, they're on Plavix, so I know, you know, I can go in and look and see what Plavix does, and that'll be helpful. One of my favorite sites out there, and I used to tell people at the college, and we also tell the PBC students and other students about this website, is biologycorner.com. Now, this one also has animal biology, but there is an anatomy complete course online. It's not an online course, but reference material for a complete course. And biologycorner.com, it's /anatomy. And they have an amazing section on cardiology. They also have one on musculoskeletal system that I absolutely love. But you can go in there, and there's a whole plethora of reference tools and even little quizlets and stuff that I think is very beneficial for you to go and peruse maybe on your free time, or if you're really wanting to kind of zone in on cardiology itself. WebMD, you got to love WebMD. The only thing I would give you a warning about WebMD and some of those like that, Mayo Clinic's another one, they've got a website. But WebMD, it never fails. If, you know, my husband looks at WebMD, he'll type in a couple symptoms or something that you can do with that website. Next thing you know, he's, you know, dying of the bubonic plague, he tells me, or something. You know, so you got to be, you know, you don't want to be a hypochondriac, not saying that he is, but you got to be very careful when you go to WebMD. But again, it has fantastic resources. Now, this is just the beginning. So once you really learn the anatomy, the terminology, and you use these resources, really get in there and learn about the disease process, and that's going to help you abstract the information you need to code to the highest specificity. I would also suggest that you just open up your ICD manual and you flip open to the cardiology section and, you know, start looking at around the 400s and just really look at the options that are in there. Now, this past week when I told him I like to read the tabular for fun, you know, I do. But what happens when you do that? You become aware of codes and diseases and disease parts of the disease process in the codes that you may not have realized existed. So if you're struggling with cardiology, those are my tips that I would tell you to do, and get into the practice of, you know, perusing through your tabular and getting to know the diseases. You don't have to memorize the codes, but you might be aware of something that you didn't know before. So cardiology is a lot of fun when you really start digging into it, though.
Do you need more medical certification training? Go to www.cco.us. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for updates.